ZkSync 2.0 public testnet is live and you can try it out for free. This video explains exactly how to try it out and also use the Mute AMM that's also built on top of ZK EVM testnet. Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investments. Hope you are well. Please hit the like button to help out the channel. For anyone new, welcome and hit the bell icon and subscribe for beginner friendly, no hype, informative crypto content. And as usual, drop all the requests, suggestions or feedback in the comments as I try to reply to each and one of you in the comment section. This is a quick disclaimer before jumping into the video. A quick disclaimer that none of the content on this channel, including this video, is financial advice. Always do your own research before investing or using any service or protocols. This video is only for education or entertainment purposes. ZkSync 2.0 finally brings ZK EVM. This allows developers to develop applications that are compatible with the Ethereum virtual machine while utilizing the zero-knowledge rollup technology. If you'd like to learn more about it, the links will be in the description. As always, for the purpose of this video, I'll be using MetaMask on the Firefox browser. If you don't have a MetaMask wallet, the full step-by-step guide on how to do that will be in the description in the top right corner. Alright, so let's get into the tutorial. The testnet is running on the Gorli network, so you need some Gorli ETH to carry out transactions on the testnet. But don't worry, you can get it for free as it's just a test network. There are a lot of places where you can get some ETH, or you can request some ETH from Faucet. I'll make sure that all the ones that I've found helpful or the ones that I use most of the time will be in the description as well. One of the ones is the Paradigm one because it's safe as well, and usually they do give out ETH. Because please note that these faucets usually have a finite amount of ETH in them, so you might not be able to request the test funds from these services at some time. In that case, you can also go into the Discord and request for them test funds from the team in the Discord group or ZkSync. The one I use most of the times is Paradigm. So if you decide to use this, or if you decide to use the other ones, all you need to do is you need to have your Ethereum address. For example, this one, I copy the address. If I go to gorli-faucet.slock.it, paste it there, and I'm not a robot, and request. If this is not working, you can try other faucets, for example, this one. So let me try and use the Paradigm one. So you go sign in with Twitter. It says that we request read-only access, so it's safe to connect. And once you're there, paste your address and drip on additional networks, claim. All right, and as you can see, it says it has been dispersed, so it might take some time to arrive on your wallet. You won't be able to see it at the moment because it's connected to Ethereum mainnet. We have to be connected to a different network, which I'll show you just in a second. So the first step is to get some test ETH, which is on Gorli network, right? So that's done. Next thing is you go to the testnet itself. So you go to portal.zkSync.io, enter. And as you can see, it says ZkSync 2.0 Gorli. Welcome to ZkSync 2.0 testnet. Connect your wallet, MetaMask, and click on next. Click connect. And as you can see, it says allow this site to switch the network. So now if you are not connected or if you have not connected to this test network previously, then you will have to add this. But if you have connected to it before, then you can just go and switch it. I'm going to go switch. So what I need to do now is I need to deposit some of my ETH to the ZkSync 2.0 from Gorli testnet. So if I go to deposit, and as you can see, it says available 0.0. So I just requested the funds. So it might take some time before you can actually see the funds here. So just keep some patience. You will definitely get some test funds after the once the faucet has delivered the ETH to you. All right, so I've just switched my wallet. So one of a different wallet, I already had some ETH for me to test at. So you can see the numbers. So if you see that I have a lot of ETH, that's because I got it a long time ago. I don't even remember from when, right? So it's always good to have some test ETH just in case. So I have 0.549 available. And now this is on Gorli. So I'm going to transfer this to ZkSync 2.0. So I'm going to transfer 0.2 deposit. If you remember in ZkSync 1, we did a similar thing where we transferred from ETH layer 1 to ZkSync. So we were doing the same thing, but on a testnet using test ETH. 0.2, confirm. So it usually takes a minute or a few seconds, a couple of minutes, depending on the congestion on network. As you can see, it says a deposit submitted. I can open that and have a look on the information if you prefer indexing. So sometimes it can take some time. This is a Gorli testnet transaction only. So once it has been deposited, what you can do is you go to faucet and now you have ETH, right? But you need other tokens as well for you to try the testnet. So ZKSync 2.0 has its own faucet that gives you other tokens such as DAI, USDC, Chainlink, and I think there's one more. So if you go to faucet, so first you deposit. Depositing is actually transferring ETH from testnet, Gorilla testnet to ZKSync 2.0 testnet. After that's done, you have your ETH. Now you need some other assets as well, because you can't directly convert that ETH to any other assets because it's testnet. So you go to faucet, click on request from faucet, and as you can see, your funds will be available shortly. So click on OK. Now if I go to my account, you will see I have USDC 300. I have LINK 50. You probably will have 100 LINK because I've already requested and I used that ETH, so I have only 50 and 300 DAI, right? You've technically already tried the testnet, right? But if you want to do other transactions or other actions, what you can do is you can go to transfer. For example, if you have other wallets, for example, if you have other test wallets, you can actually withdraw or you can actually transfer these funds to that wallet. So please remember, this is not real assets. This is on testnet. So if you transfer, it will go to the testnet, not the main layer one Ethereum. If it's confusing, please let me know in the comments below. I'll try to explain and see if I can help you out. But if you want transfer, you can just transfer your assets to other wallets, USDC, Wrapped, BTC, LINK, and DAI as well. So you can try it out. You can try different things. You can try all the options here and get a feel and get a better understanding of ZKSync 2.0, which is testnet. We'll probably have more features and more apps in the future. The other thing that I want to show you is Mute testnet. So Mute is developing an AMM launchpad and a couple of other things on ZKSync. So they have testnet. So I do suggest that you try out that testnet as well. So as you can see, I've gone to testnet. It says it wants to switch network. Click on switch network, that's fine. So what you can do is you can do different things. You can do swap, you can add liquidity, you can farm that liquidity tokens as well. So just do a couple of swaps. So let's say if I go, let me convert DAI to LINK. So if I convert 150 to LINK, can be a bit slow. So depending on the time or day you're doing, you might have to wait some time before it's actually going, before the transactions go through. I'll approve that, sign the transaction. Sign that again. And as you can see, the transaction cost 0.0. So this is just a preview of how the AMM will work in the future. So you can imagine once ZKSync is fully rolled out and we have applications on it, we're going to pay a few cents for transactions. You can imagine that how easy everyone's life's going to be once we have these protocols and these framework implemented. That's that. So that's how to swap. If you go to pool, you can provide liquidity. For example, you can create a pair or you can add liquidity to any pair that's existent. For example, if I try USDC and DAI, so let me provide liquidity for $150, should populate itself. You click on supply. Let me sign that as well. It's working pretty good at the moment, but you might, if you face a bit longer wait times, just make sure that you understand that that is expected. As you can see, the transaction cost 55 cents, usually costs $67 or maybe even more, depending on the congestion. Sometimes it takes $80, $90 to provide liquidity, remove liquidity, all that stuff. That's done. So what I can do is I can go to farming and I can actually farm those tokens. You can provide liquidity to ETH or slash DAI. So if you want to farm as well, you can go add liquidity for ETH and DAI. For example, 0.2, 1, 2, 3. All right, supply, sign. All right, so I've provided liquidity, go to farming, click on that, connect, go max, approve. So as you know, the ZKSync is going to be community owned, which means that community will be provided the tokens once it's launched, when it's launched. So you might be increasing your chances by participating in the testnet. ZKSync had a testnet for ZKSync first edition or the ZKSync 1.0. Similar way they have this as well. So it doesn't hurt to participate. No one knows what the criteria will be to be eligible for the airdrop in the future, but this is good for you because you'll get to learn how to use these platforms once they are fully rolled out, and it will give you an advantage as well. So it's always good, and I encourage a lot to try out new platforms and try out new technologies in crypto, instead of sticking to the same narrative that you have or the same protocols and services you have. All right, so that's deposited. All right, so if I go to collect, I can see that my deposit is there and these are the rewards that I will collect. So that's how to use Mute testnet and how to use ZK Sync 2.0's testnet on Coral Network. Please let me know if you've run into any issues or if you have any questions. If you've made it to this part of the video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, as that helps out the channel a lot. If you have any suggestions, any queries, leave them in the comments as usual. And you have a nice day, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.